मम्मी कहती कि वह एक रिस्क ही था, वह बहुत बड़ा खतरा लेकर चीजों को ले जाती थी, इसलिए उसे रोकना, उसे हर्ट करना होता, आखिर वह हमारे वेलबींग के लिए ही तो ले जा रही थी। My mother seemed to notice that I was not entirely convinced. She looked at me reprovingly and after that we spoke no more about it. Whenever mother was asked, interrogated by child that this girl that she should not let carry the things to the other home, then her mother used to look towards that girl in reproving way. Reproving means condemn, alochanatmak way, that child should not ask such questions. Meanwhile, I had arrived at the station without having paid much attention to things on the way. I was walking in familiar places again for the first time since the war, but I did not want to go further than was necessary. I did not want to upset myself with the sight of streets and houses full of memories from a precious time. Girl is saying that when she was returning to her home, she reached home, but she did not take care of the things. She did not notice things which were on the way. And anyhow, she was first time after long time on that path after the World War II. And she did not want to notice those things because if she noticed those things, then those things hurt her. In the train back, I saw Mrs. Darling in front of me again as I had the first time I met her. It was the morning after the day my mother had told me about her. I had got up late and coming downstairs, I saw my mother about to see someone out, a woman with a broad bag. Narrator is saying that, this girl is saying that once what happened when that girl was traveling with the mother and reached at home. She was sleeping when her mother was waking up, and that friend of mother was also at home. And when that friend was departing from home to her home, then meanwhile that girl woke up and saw the back side of that lady that was the very broad. वह जो थी लड़की सो कर उठी और वो जो मम्मी की उसकी फ्रेंड थी वो जा रही थी, तभी वह लड़की उनको पीछे से देखी, तो वो कह रही कि ब्रॉड बैक, वो पीछे साइड से उनका साइज देखी, बैक देखी, तो देखी कि बहुत लंबी चौड़ी औरत थी और वही चीज उसे याद था। देयर इज माई डॉटर, सेड माई मदर, एंड देन मदर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाई सेइंग दैट दैट लिटिल किड वाज और सी वाज हर डॉटर। सी बिकंड टू मी मीन्स लुक्ड सीरियसली टुवर्ड्स हर। The woman nodded and picked up the suitcase under the coat rack. She wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. That lady took suitcase, put on some clothes. Does she live far away? I asked, seeing the difficulty she had going out of the house with the heavy case. And then, when that lady started to go by taking the suitcase filled with the belongings to that girl and her mother, then that girl again inquired of with her mother whether she was going somewhere else far away by taking those suitcases. In Marconi Street, said my mother, number 46, remember that. Then mother replied that she was going to the Marconi Street number 46, and further mother instructed to keep in memory that number, street number 46. I had remembered it, and after hearing one time narrator, that is the girl, memorized that number 46 in her mind, street 46. But I had waited a long time to go there, but she committed so long late to go there. Initially, after the liberation, I was absolutely not interested in all that stored stuff, and naturally I was also rather afraid of it, afraid of being confronted with things that had belonged to a connection that no longer existed, which were hidden away in cupboards and boxes and waiting in vain until they were put back in their place again, which had endured all those years because they were things. Narrator Carey hai, that girl is saying that she committed so long late in taking her belongings back from that lady because she did not want to receive those things. Reason was given by her, a reason here is being given by her, that old things are the memories of past connections. And if past connections are in good position, if you are in good position in past connection, and after some time you become in adverse and worse situation, खराब स्थिति में होते हो और उन अतीत की चीजों को आप देखते हो तो वो अतीत की याद दिलाती हैं और इस तरह से अतीत की याद आती है तो आपको कष्ट होता है, दुख होता है by memorizing the past things, past incidents. So due to that reason, that girl was not ready to take back those things from the friend of her mother. Yet more than this, she is saying that things are things. Those are not more valuable than the human being and feelings and emotions of the human being. If they are put in cupboard, then they lie there silently because they are the things. If they are put just before a human being, they are put just before human being because they are the things. So they are the lifeless. There is no need to run after them in relation to the past memories because they are the things. But if you will see things, then you will recall in your memory the past memories which are not present at the moment, particularly if those things are belonging to the your near dear, and that near dear is not between you, then those things only what will do? They will do only a work of hurt to you. Means those things will hurt by recalling the past good memories in relation to you and your near and dear. And वो लड़की कह रही है कि अगर अतीत की चीजों को हम ले लें, देखें, और यदि वो चीजें हमारे सुखद अनुभव से जुड़ी हुई हैं और वर्तमान में हम दुखद परिस्थिति में हैं और उन अतीत की चीजों को हम देखते हैं, तो इन दैट सिचुएशन व्हाट हैपेंस, हम उन चीजों को देखकर बहुत दुखी होते हैं क्योंकि वो चीजें हमें अवेलेबल नहीं होती हैं, वो अतीत की चीजें हमें परिस्थितियां नहीं लौट कर आ सकती, और पार्टिकुलरली वह चीजें, निर्जीव चीजें इतना दुख देती हैं जब अगर वह चीजें हमारे किसी नियर डियर से जुड़ी हुई हों तब. So due to this reason, that girl did not try to receive those things back from the friends of her mother. But gradually, that is slowly, everything became more normal again. Bread was getting to be a lighter color. There was a bed by bed you could sleep in unthreatened, a room with a view you were more used to glancing at each day. And one day I noticed I was curious about all the possessions that must still be at that address. I wanted to see them, touch, remember. But that girl was not agree to carry those things in her home which were belonging to her and belonging to the past memories, good past memories. Yet after passing long time, the effect of the world war removed, feathered, withered, kam ho gaya, ghat gaya uska dusprabhav. Everything was in normal situation. Everyone could sleep peacefully, silently in his her room, on her bed, under the quilt or whatever thing for the spreading on the body. Then that girl realized some attraction towards those things. And then she decided to come in contact to see those things, to touch and to remember, to memorize the past memories, to bring those things to her home. After my first visit in vain to Mrs. Darling's house, in vain means in null, bekar, sunya mein. Keh rahi hai ki jab main first visit kar li, and that was fruitless visit. Miss gayi, Darling mana kar di, Mrs. Darling jo ki unki friend thi, mummy ki keh rahi main to tumhe pehchanti nahi, out. तो कह रहे कि that was in vain, बेकार था, fruitless था. House I decided to try a second time. Now a girl of about 15 opened the door to me. I asked her if her mother was at home. When second time this girl visited to the home, Mrs. Darling's home, street number 46. Then at that moment, that lady, Mrs. Darling, was not at home. A 15-year-old teen girl opened the door. This girl asked where the kid's mother was on home. No, she said. Child replied, no, my mother's doing an errand. Miss, my mother is... That girl replied that her mother was on some other place for the purchasing purpose in the market. No matter, I said, I will wait for her. And girl, then this girl found chance and said that, okay, it does not matter whether she was at home or not. And she was ready to wait to the Mrs. Darling by sitting in her home. ये लड़की कही कोई बात नहीं, मम्मी नहीं है तो मैं एंट्री कर जो है वेट कर लूंगी तुम्हारे मम्मी की. I followed the girl along the passage and when girl entered into the room by following that little kid, an old fashioned iron Hanukkah candle holder hung next to a mirror. We never used it because it was much more cumbersome. Cumbersome means होता है difficultful, use में दिक्कत. आप प्रयोग तो करेंगे चीजें लेकिन थोड़ा दिक्कत होती है, जगह ज्यादा खेती है. That is called cumbersome. CUMBERSOME. That a single candlestick. कह रही है कि वो जो होता है ऐसे होता है, उसमें तीन चार पांच वो होता है, उसमें आप कैंडल या दिया जला सकते हो. इधर 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 राउंड में होता है, स्टैंड पे खड़ा होता है. जब पूजा वगैरह में आप लोग देखते हो तो वो थोड़ा बड़ा उस समय होता था. तो दैट वाज कंबरसम फॉर हर. सो गर्ल इज सेइंग दैट व्हेन शी सॉ दैट कैंडल स्टिक देन शी सेड आर केम टू नो रियलाइज दैट दैट कैंडल स्टिक वाज नॉट बिलोंगिंग हर बिकॉज दे डिड नॉट यूज सच टाइप ऑफ कंबरसम कैंडल स्टिक. इवन दे used a single candle to lit for a light because that was easy to use than the cumbersome light stick, candle stick. Would not you sit down, asked the girl. Girl requested to sit. That girl, she held open the door of the living room and I went inside past her. Past her means following her, behind her. After invitation to enter into and sit on respective place, this girl followed her, entered into the room, and I went inside past her. I stopped horrified. Horrified means get feared, get something surprised in negative way. I was in a room I knew and did not know. Dekho, what is meaning? I was in the room means that girl was in the room. I knew that girl was knowing that she was in the room and did not know, but not knowing. मतलब हिंदी में समझो, इसे तुम लोग इंग्लिश में नहीं समझ पाओगे. वह लड़की यह जान रही थी कि वो रूम में एंट्री कर गई है, घर में एंट्री कर गई है, इस बात को वह जानती थी, बट फिर भी वह उससे अनजान थी कि वो रूम में एंट्री कर गई है. मींस हर अटेंशन वाज टोटली, हर साइकोलॉजिकल अटेंशन वाज टोटली टुवर्ड्स द थिंग, नॉट टुवर्ड्स हर फिजिकल अपीयरेंस दैट वेयर स्टैंडिंग सी वाज. समझ में आया? आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर नाउ. I knew and did not know. I found myself in the midst of things. Girl is saying that she found herself among the things I did want to see again, but which oppressed me in the strange atmosphere. When she was at that moment among those things to which she wanted to see, to touch, to recall. अब वह रूम में एंट्री करके उन चीजों के बीच चली गई थी जिन्हें वह देखना जानना चाहती थी, छूना चाहती थी, याद करना चाहती थी, क्योंकि बिकॉज दोज थिंग्स बिलोंग्ड टू हर विच वेयर कैरीड बाई द मिसेस डार्लिंग फ्रॉम हर मदर फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ हाइडिंग एंड इन फ्यूचर टू रिटर्न. मिसेस डार्लिंग वो इनके सामान लाई थी कि हम अपने घर में छिपा के रखेंगे, जरूरत पड़ेगी तुम लोग मांगोगे तो दे देंगे, क्योंकि वर्ल्ड वार में लोग पलायन कर रहे थे इधर से उधर. जातिवाद था, कास्टिज्म था, उस वजह से जो कमजोर जात के लोग थे भाग रहे थे, स्ट्रांग जात के लोग इनको दबा रहे थे, तो वो जो किलिंग वगैरह का मैटर चल रहा था, तो वैसे में वो लाती थी कि हम छिपा देंगे और बाद में हमसे ले लेना. तो दोस्त थिंग्स, इसीलिए वो गर्ल कह रही है कि सी वाज इन द रूम, सी वाज अवेयर ऑफ, वह जानती थी कि रूम में है, लेकिन अब भूल जाएगी थी अपना अस्तित्व कि वह रूम में है, क्योंकि नाउ हर अटेंशन वाज टोटली टुवर्ड्स दोस थिंग्स व्हिच वेयर बिलोंगिंग टू हर एंड शी वाज बिजी इन ऑब्जर्विंग ऑल दोस थिंग्स. Strange atmosphere oppressed me in the strange atmosphere and now seeing those things, she was totally in strange atmosphere under strange pressure, psychological pressure, or because of the tasteless way everything was arranged, because of the ugly furniture or the muggy smell. Muggy means badbudar stink smell that hung there. I don't know, but I scarcely dare to look around me. Whole sense of this line is that girl was totally horrified, stunned, and totally in amazing, surprising situation. She was totally in psychological pressure. She could not decide what she should do and what she should not do. The girl moved a chair. I sat down and stared at the woolen tablecloth. Girl sat down. Miss girl gave the chair to sit on this girl. And finding the chair, she sat down at that chair and stared at the woolen tablecloth. Woolen tablecloth means the before on which chair she sat. Just in on front, very near on front of the table chair, there was a table, and that table was covered with a woolen cloth, woolen knitted, woolen था उसपे बुनाई की गई थी और उसे वह table ढका हुआ था. I rubbed it. That girl who was sitting there in search of her things, rub it means रगड़ लगाई. My fingers grew warm from rubbing. I followed the lines of the pattern somewhere on the edge. There should be a burn mark that had never been repaired. And when that girl started to rub her fingers got warm, and she started to rub further round by round at the edge of the table with the purpose knowing whether that table was the same table which belonged to her. Because if it had been belonged to her, then it had burned. It must have burned marks. Burnt, जला हुआ होता है ना, जलना, तो burnt symbol mark on it. मतलब इस लड़की का टेबल जो था कहीं न कहीं किसी कारण से कैंडल से या जैसे भी जल गया था. तो लड़की जो थी पहले एक जगह रब की, फिर उसके बाद रब करते करते किनारे किनारे हर तरफ गई कि अगर बर्न होगा यह टेबल मेरा ही होगा, तो जरूर कहीं ना कहीं बर्न होगा. और जो जला था किनारे, तो तय सी बात है कि अब तक रिपेयर नहीं हुआ होगा, तो मैं समझ जाऊंगी कि यह टेबल मेरा ही है. My mother will be back soon, said the girl. Girl consoled by saying to that girl that her mother will be soon back at home. I have already made tea for her. Will you have a cup? And she invited to have a cup to that girl. Thanks you. And in lieu of the offering of the tea, cup of tea, this girl, young girl, thanked to that kid girl. I looked up. Okay, beta, thank you. ऐसा है कि अब यहीं पर वीडियो बड़ा हो जाएगा तो अपलोड करने में दिक्कत होगी. Okay.